It was back to basics for the remaining six candidates in last night's Apprentice. Each team was given £250 worth of wholesale goods, and they had to work out what sold best before reinvesting in those products, turning stock into cash as many times as possible.
Smell what sells.
Smell what sells.
Awesome, wasn't it? It might sound simple enough in theory. What about in practice? Both teams struggled to target the right customers, leading to yet another fierce boardroom battle. Who got fired? Find out now.
I don't know how many more times, I sound like a broken record now, how many more times I've spoken about your last chance, you're not showing yourself. Whether this is the last time that we're going to see each other in this process, it very much depends on how much weight I give to the fact that you did try to show me something that you claim not to be good at, and that is selling. Mm-hmm. That's to your credit. The person going today doesn't necessarily mean that they're a failure in any way or form. It means they're not made for me, really. And on that basis, I have to say that it is with regret, Melody, that you're fired.
Tom thought it was him.
He did.
Tom. Hello, Melody. Nice to see you.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning. So why weren't you for Lord Sugar?
I guess that's for him to decide. And I think because it's him going into business with someone, his view is what counts. Mm-hmm. And that's fair enough. But I really wanted it. I was there to win it.
Well, and one of the advisors said, I can't remember which one it was, suggested that if you were to go into business with him, the boardroom discussions would go on for a very long time, in suggesting that perhaps he talked a bit too much. What do you think? Is that fair?
I think that it's reassuring to know that if I'm pushed, and these are extreme circumstances, don't forget, you know, you're really fighting for your chance, that I am able to speak up and get myself heard. But I don't know. I think that might be a valid point in some circumstances. I do get really passionate about it, and I certainly was in that last boardroom.
There was a fair bit of teasing throughout the series about the fact, I mean, you're young, you're 26. You can speak five languages. You set up a youth organisation at the age of 13.
With other people, yeah.
Okay. You say you've worked with 12 Nobel Peace Prize winners, including Desmond Tutu, the Dalai Lama, and Al Gore. It just sounds, you look at that and it just sounds improbable. Can you understand why people are thinking, she hasn't really, come on, she hasn't really been with the Dalai Lama? And with Desmond Tutu.
Yeah, and it certainly has been very amusing for me to watch people's reactions and stuff online. But I come from a place where we don't have much opportunities, and I've just been, I go for opportunities, I grab it, I take it, I'm grateful for it, and I make the most of it.
Mm, but you didn't grab the opportunity to buy the right things when it came to restocking. It was the curse of the nodding dog for you. Let's see what happened, because it led to some dissent, didn't it?
I feel like Melody isn't really taking charge at all. She doesn't seem to be organised or seem to even grasp the concept of what we're meant to be doing.
Digital alarm clock.
Yeah.
Which is a really good product, actually. It's got a digital photo frame. That's £5.49. 20 of these.
I wish I'd have put myself forward as project manager. I want to keep a clean sheet. And I think I at least would have had a strategy and been organised and got on with things, whereas at the moment we're just floundering.
Oh, this might be a good idea.
But you should have bought more nodding dogs.
Nodding
dogs
were screaming at the get more nodding dogs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Reinvest.
Yeah, nodding dogs. That's it now, and my life has just been nodding dogs. We reinvested three times during that task, and we reinvested
but not in the
something
dogs.
That sold, but in phone chargers, and that did sell. I mean, I had a strategy. My strategy was electrical items, and I was clear with that. I stuck to my guns, and I went with that.
See, I was surprised at what happened to you, because it was week one you were project manager, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And you did really well. And up there, I remember people writing papers saying, oh, well, Melody's going to walk it.
And he liked you. Lord Sugar really seemed to like you as well, because you did fight in the boardroom.
So is there a specific mistake that you can point to that you made that cost you in the end?
I think it was just... I don't know. I think I made mistakes, definitely. And I think some of the market research, for example, I just become so passionate about something and I push it. But I never pretended I was the finished product, and I'm not now. And I don't think no one ever is. And there's a long way to go, but this certainly marks a new chapter for me and all the exciting work that I'm doing now.
Yeah, there was a lot of sort of what exactly do you do, Melody, yeah, in the boardroom as well. So what exactly do you do? Just
well,
to clarify this.
Check our websites, have a look at some of our portfolios. But the exciting things that we've got coming up are, you know, youth unemployment is now higher than ever. And we're tackling some of that with real skills and support for young people.
What are you doing?
Next month, we're holding a skills development seminar with real sort of support, real visioning exercises, real strategic. So that's exciting. And another thing that we're doing, which I'm really, really excited about, is we're going into high crime areas, we're working with neighbourhood police teams and sort of implementing long-term strategies to bring communities together. So watch this space, check our website, connect to us on Facebook, and lots of information.
We haven't heard the last of you,
no.
And you did say that you had a fair amount of criticism, so I'm going to leave you this from Rishi, who writes in this morning. Melody, not just a pretty face, the epitome of hard-working, confident and resilient. To achieve what she has at such a young age is remarkable. She has so much potential and will continue to go far in life. So
that
take that away with you.
Thank you.
And look at it.
Thank you very
often.
Much. I really appreciate it.
To be honest, I don't think she's short of confidence, really.
Do you?
Melody, thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Now,